Hello boys and girls, Mike here, one go short play. Talking quietly again because there we go. So that was a YouTube video going up. Funnily enough, one of the people I follow. I'll have a look at that in a bit. Now, 1943, Battle of Midway, the USA release of the game for the NES. Let's have a little look. Can I actually buy... Oh, I've got points. Offensive power. Defensive power. Energy level. Special weapon. Something time limit. Actually, I don't want that. Oh, too late. I've picked it. I don't want that. Oh. I wanted energy level. I want to be able to take hits. Oh no, I could have said no. Never mind. Let's just fight baby. Here we go. It's the 1940-something intro. There's that little cutscene there. It did go... Oh, the music's there. Yeah, this feels like the game. The first one's all whistling sound effects, as far as I remember the arcade. Ah, and I've got the auto fire button. Let's see if this gives me the advantage. I do love the 1942 music. 1943, sorry, music. The 1942 office music. I only played it the other day, I should know really. Alright. Clicking some playing, but much easier when you've got an auto fire button. And actually really, really fun. That was tricky. The underbelly of those planes is white, and those clouds, well, they're white. Oh no, whatever it is. Yes! Look at this! Look at this! Well, I'm having fun because I'm not dying. One that. Yeah, more bullets. Wow, this is on a NES. That is a lot of spike flicker. But it really doesn't matter. I'm starting to believe what people say about the NES. Whee! Oh wow! Did I do that? Apparently so. And in this one, your bullet that you move is also accompanied by a lightning bolt, which is kind of cool. Can't complain about that. Convincing attack. Oh, Midnight Resistance, that music. At least on the Amiga. I don't really know. Well, I'm the Spectrum. I don't really know what any other versions sound like because I never played them, but I did play the Spectrum version. The arcade version. I was a bit disappointed with it. I want that. Nice. Oh, I'm very liking the excitement. Am I waking you up with my excitement? He's just nodded off. We've had a massive play. We've got in from work, we've had our tea, we've had a massive play, and a massive bath. This one loves baths. He absolutely loves having a bath. He hates getting out. We always have a crying match when we try and get him out of the bath. No matter how long we leave him in for to play. And it gets splashy. I've had to have a little change of costume. Whoa. Keeping you up there. Yeah, that's a little costume change because I got soaked by Splashy Splash here. This is good. I'm only really enjoying it though because I'm not dying yet. Somehow I managed to survive that level without losing my life. That somehow is auto fire. But I'm not proud. That sounds good. It kind of had a quality to it, which is cool. Although, I do feel I probably should have kept my power-ups. Oh, still cool. Still incredibly cool. That's maybe my favourite incarnation of this game. And I've got it on an arcade machine in the office. Love that. Look at that. I'm going to see if I can power this up. That would be awesome. And, you know, the arcade machine's good, but... The problem with these games on arcade machines is, I wouldn't say they lack challenge because they do have it, but don't forget you have infinite lives on an arcade machine. Because on the arcades it was all about how much money you put in. on a cabinet like mine, I've just put a button in that basically means insert coin. And it kind of, I'd say it takes the fun out of games, because it really doesn't. But it does mean you never have to worry about dying. And that takes something away from the game, you know? I guess. I know there's an element of, ooh, I took a hit there. I know there's an element of panic here, because I can die, even though I'm having a hard time doing it. It is going to happen at some point, because I've taken two hits now. Sorry, little wriggler. He didn't long go off, so he's probably not that deep asleep. So he may wake up after being a go and try and take over. We know what happens when he wakes up. He tries to take over. See my last video for details. Ooh, I am taking some kickings now. I'm so gonna die. Come on, Mikey. It's good though, this, isn't it? I mean, it, you know what? It's weirdly reminiscent of Strider on the Mega Drive, where the music's kind of changing mood for the different sections of the level. I never minded that on Strider, it didn't do it musically and rhythmically, you know, it just kind of cut with the scenes. And it worked for me. I liked it. Oh, and I'm talking to somebody who's made music for games. I loved it. And this has got a bit of that. That was actually game over. You know what? That was awesome. I'm going to leave it there, though, and play some more games. 1943, the US version, which is called the Battle of Midway, for the NES. I'm going to have a go at the Japanese version. I'm hoping that it's a bit different, because I want an excuse to play it again. Thanks for watching. Hello, boys and girls. Mike here, One Go Short Play, playing 1943 again, but the Japanese release, which is called the Battle of Valhalla. Now, I'm not sure what the Battle of Midway was, or what the Battle of Valhalla is. Let's just power up my firepower. We know what that means now. It's just the Japanese. But Valhalla's got something to do with Vikings, hasn't it? It's where they go and they die, isn't it? Something like that. I don't know. Oh, that was magic. Oh, wow, that's awesome. I've just used them all up. But I don't care. Oh, I see, that's my energy. Let's not use that up. Oh, and I'll pause the game. Let's not use it. Oh, see, that music comes when your energy's really low. I better do something about it, if I can. That's awesome, the music changes when your energy gets low. That's your warning that you're about to die. I'm about to die because I just used... That lightning was actually in my health. It's the same game. I just want to play it again. Because it's good. I didn't last very long that time. Okay, we know it's the same game. What I'll do is I'll put this video on that video, and then you can see that. Okay, thanks for watching. Bye. Hello, boys and girls. Mike here, One Go Short Play, playing 1943 again, but the Japanese release, which is called The Battle of Valhalla. Now, I'm not sure what the Battle of Midway was, or what the Battle of Valhalla is. Let's just power up my firepower. We know what that means now. It's just the Japanese. But Valhalla's got something to do with Vikings, hasn't it? It's where they go and they die, isn't it? Something like that. I don't know. Oh, that was magic. Oh, wow, that's awesome. I've just used them all up. But I don't care. Oh, I see, that's my energy. Let's not use that up. Oh, and I'll pause the game. Let's not use it. Oh, see, that music comes when your energy's really low. I better do something about it, if I can. That's awesome, the music changes when your energy gets low. That's your warning that you're about to die. I'm about to die because I just used... That lightning was actually in my health. It's the same game. I just want to play it again. Because it's good. I didn't last very long that time. Okay, we know it's the same game. What I'll do is I'll put this video on that video. And then you can see that. Okay. Thanks for watching. Bye.